All right. Let me give you another question. Try to solve it. X square minus 1 dy by dx plus 2xy equals to 1 upon x square minus 1. All right, few minutes for this. Send me the answers. सॉल्व इट एवरीवन। अहमद हैव यू सॉल्व इट?
डूइंग सो।
ऑल राइट। एलन, जीवा, लायन?
I'm doing it, sir.
All right, tell me when you're done. In this question, it is x square minus 1 and this is x square minus 1. All right, let's see. First, let's check the integrating factor. To the power integration of p dx, and p is 2x upon x square minus 1. But we can use substitution here. So if you put x square minus 1 as t, you will get 2x as 2x dx as dt. So this becomes e to the power integration of dt upon t, which is e to the power log mod t, which is t, and this value is x square plus 1. Right, everyone? Integrating factor is clear? Okay. Solution would be y into integrating factor equals to integration of integrating factor into q dx. So y into x square minus 1 equals to integration of x square minus 1, 1 upon x square minus 1 whole square dx. So this is cancelled. You just have to integrate this, you'll get the answer. All right? Ahmed, this thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
All right.
So Alan, Jiva, you substitute the formula, right?
Which formula?
1/2 log for,
yes, you have to use this formula here. This is 1 upon x square minus a square.
So
Alan, Jiva, Ryan?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, please.
All right, note it down. Let's try another question. Dy by dx plus y sec x equals to tan x. Right, few minutes for this also. Tell me when you are done. Hello, Gonzalo. All right, solid even. The answer to this is y sec x plus tan x equals to sec x plus tan x minus x plus c. All right, integrating factor is sec x plus tan x. All right. Ahmed, Allen, Jeeva, Kinza, Ryan. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. So this was type one of linear differential equation. Type two is when they will give you equation like this, dx upon dy plus rx equals to s. So we can compare this to this, dy upon dx plus px equals to q, right? Py equals to q, solve. All right. So in here, the integrating factor was e to the power ptx. Here, integrating factor will be e to the power r dy. The solution was y integrating factor equals to integration integrating factor q dx. Here, the solution will be x integrating factor equals to integration of s integrating factor dy. Right? Yes or no, everyone?
Can you explain again?
All right. If the equation is in the variable dy by dx, right, and py equals to q, where p and q are functions of x, then this is type 2, where the equation will be formed in this form, dx upon dy plus rx equals to s, where r and s will be functions of y. All right. So in this case, we have been solving questions like this. Integrating factor is e to the power integration p dx. In this case, it will be same, right? R dy. We are changing x in the place of y. So solution is y integrating factor equals to integration of integrating factor q. Same thing is here. X integrating factor equals to integration s integrating factor dy. Clear now?
Yes, sir.
All right, please note it down. All right, guys, try to solve this. All right. Ryan, how are you getting the answer as 2? You will be getting an equation. Right? See, from here we can get y x equals to 2y square dy. The dy equals to x 2y power 1 by. Is the dy equals to x y plus 2y by. Am I audible, everyone? Or is my voice lagging? Just 1 minute. Now is it clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
All right. So this thing, these steps are clear, all of you?
Yes.
Yes or no? All right. So the value of R is here, minus 1 upon y, s is 2y. Now you can find the values very clearly. All right. Yes or no?
Yes.
Can you complete the question?
All right. So integrating factor will be e to the power integration r dy. So this is e to the power integration of minus 1 upon y dy. This is e to the power minus log of mod of y, which is e to the power log 1 upon y. So 1 upon y. This thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
So the final answer is x integrating factor equals to integration of integrating factor s dy. So x by y equals to integrating factor is 1 upon y, s is 2y dy. This is also cancelled, right? So x by y equals to integration of 2 is 2y plus c. This thing is clear?
Yes.
Everyone, this thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. Note it down. I'll give you a few more questions. All right. Next question on this. Y dx plus x minus y cube dy equals to 0. Right, very simple question. Now you have to think which form is this, dx upon dy or dy by dx. All right. And the answer to this question is xy equals to y to the power 4 upon 4 plus c. All right. Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.
All right. Next question. A to the power minus 2 root x divided by root x minus y upon root x dx upon dy equals to 1. All right. Few minutes for this also. All right. So if I throw this dy by dx to this side, we can write dy by dx equals to e to the power minus 2 root x upon root x minus y upon root x. We can bring this to that side. So this is dy by dx plus y upon root x equals to e to the power minus 2 root x upon root x. Now we can find integrating factor. Integration e to the power integration of p is 1 upon root x and dx. This is e to the power minus half dx integration. So e to the power 2 root x. This thing is clear? Yes or no, everyone? The solution of this differential equation is y times integrating factor equals to integration of e times minus 2 root x into e to the power root x upon root x dx. You can find this integration, right? This is cancelled. So 1 upon root x integration, everyone knows. Kinza, this thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. Note it down, guys. Tell me when you're done. All right. Ryan, you can find this by dx tan y equals to minus of x minus sine y dy. This we can write dx upon dy equals to minus of x minus sine y whole divided by tan y. So this is dx upon dy equals to minus x upon tan y plus sine y upon tan y. So this is equal to dx upon dy plus x upon tan y equals to sine y upon tan y, and this is cos y. All right. So now you can find integrating factor and solve this, right, Ryan?
Yes.
Right. This is type 2. So please solve it, guys. Send me the answer. All right, guys. Answer to this question is x sine y equals to minus 1 upon 4 cos 2y plus c. All right. All right, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this chapter is over. All right. This was all about differential equation. I hope everyone is clear about this. Kinza, Jeeva, Ryan, Ahmed.
Yes, sir.
All right. No doubts. All right. The next chapter of this is class 12th is vectors. Very easy chapter. Now all the chapters are very simple. Just do not be absent in the class and you will be able to solve all the questions. All right. So what is vectors? You already know, I believe there are two kind of things in this world, scalar and vector. Scalar is something which does not have direction. It has only magnitude. All right. A vector has magnitude and direction. All right. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. So if I ask you, I'm writing few things. You have to answer if these are scalar and vector on chat. All right. I need everyone's answer. Vector is something that has magnitude and direction. Please send me the answer on chat, which is scalar, which is vector. All right, very simple. Right, 5 second. This is scalar. 1000 cm³. This is volume. This is also scalar. 10 N forces vector. 30 km/h. This is scalar. Right, no direction is given. This is density, scalar. This is vector. All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. How to represent a vector? We write like this: AB vector, right? Suppose this is A and B. There is arrow. This is called initial point. This is called terminal point. All right. We can represent like this also. Right, everyone?
Yes, sir.
All right. Write down a question. Represent geographically a displacement of 40 km 30° west of south. All right. Represents geographically a displacement of 40 km 30° west of south. Very simple question. All right. Very simple. This is east, west, north, and south. So 30° west of south. So like this, this is 30° and displacement of 40 km, right? This will be the geometrical representation. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. And when is your school reopening, guys?
So coming Sunday.
Coming Sunday. All right. So we can keep a few extra classes, right? Here and there. Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. So we'll update you about the extra class. Please be present. All right. All right, everyone. Jeeva, Kinza, Ryan.
Yes, sir.
All right. So this is all for today's class. Take care and please complete all the assignments of differential equation. See you in the next class.
Thank you.
Ryan, they are saying 30 degree west of south. All right. So always in this type of questions, stand at the south. All right. Of south, that means you are standing at the south. 30 degree west. So move towards west by 30 degree.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, then take care. Sir. All right.
Sir.
Yes, Kinza.
Wo jo abhi Friday ko test hua tha. So I wanted to know the answers. I have some confusion with the case-based questions.
You want to know the solution? All right. I'll talk to the team. They'll send you the solutions. All right. Or do you need to discuss the questions?
Yes, sir. Can you just explain those cases? It's so confusing.
Actually, I did not make the question paper, so I do not. Like, I have not seen the question paper. Let me just look at that. Just give me 1 minute. I'm asking the team to send me the question paper.
Sure. All right.
You have sent me this case study. Read the following temperature. Okay, this is continuity and differentiability question, right, Kinza?
Yes, sir.
So, how do we check continuity? We all did a few backup classes, right, of this?
Yes, sir.
So, can you tell me how to check the differentiability of something like
how to check?
Hello? LSD, RSD, left hand derivative, right hand derivative.
I really don't remember.
All right, this is limit x tending to c, f of c minus f of x whole divided by c minus x. Write yes. It down. All right. And if they ask you about LHD, then what happens? We'll just change this limit x tending to. All right, limit extending to c minus f of x, c minus x. All right, this is LHD.
Yes, sir.
And RHD will be c plus. Oh, I wrote in this. All right, please write it down. Very important. Thank you. And actually, you do not have to know this because the function, if you see, or let me just change this. Write it down that all the logarithmic functions all the polynomial function logarithmic function exponential function are differentiable in its domain. All right?
Yes, sir.
So if you see the function here is f of x equals to minus 0.1 x square plus mx plus 98.6, right? So this is a
yes.
polynomial function, quadratic equation.
Right? Yes, sir.
If you like use some jugaad into this, you know that quadratic equation graph is a parabola.
Yes, sir.
Right? And parabola is very smooth, right? So this is differentiable at all the points, right?
Yes, sir.
But please remember that also, LHT and RHT.
Yes, sir.
We are saying if 6 is the critical point of the function, then find the value of constant M. All right. What is critical point?
The point where it the continuity stops.
Right. Or we can say that f dash x is 0.
Yes, sir.
Right, because see, polynomial graph are continuous and differentiable at all the values. So we can see differentiation is 0. That would be the critical point. So just initiate it. Minus 0.2x plus m equals to 0. Right?
Yes, sir.
So we can find by this m is 0.2x. They must have given some other hint also. 6 is the critical point, right?
Yes, so sir.
They have given the value of x. X is minus, m by 0.2. So they are saying this value is 6. So m will be 1.2. This thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. Find the intervals in strictly increasing, strictly decreasing. Okay, you are having doubts in this chapter, continuity, differentiability, everything, maxima, minima, increasing, decreasing.
This I can find the interval. I can find maximum, minimum. I guess I have problem.
Maximum.
And this.
All right. There are two ways to figure out maxima, minima, right?
Yes.
First
sir.
Derivative test and second derivative test.
Yes, sir.
Right. So what happens in first derivative test is you differentiate and find critical points.
Yes, sir.
Just like this. Right. Then you plot those critical points on the number line.
Yes, sir.
And start with plus, minus, plus, minus. Right?
Yes, sir.
If the sign changes from minus to plus, then this thing is a minima. All right?
Yes, sir.
If the sign changes from plus to minus, this thing is a maxima. All right? That means x equals to a is a minima, x equals to b is a maxima.
Yes, sir.
So tell me if x equals to c is minima or maxima?
Minima.
Minima. All right?
Yes, sir.
This way you can find or the second derivative test. Just give me 1 minute. All right, just give me this. Let me write this example. You can solve this question also. Let me explain second derivative. Second derivative is you first differentiate. All right, and put 0. Find critical point. All right.
Yes, sir.
Suppose critical points are A, B, and C. Solid.
Yes.
Then what you do is differentiate this function again. All right. And do not do anything. Just put these values. F dash A, F double dash B, F double dash C. All right.
Yes, sir.
If you get F double dash C as positive, then this is a minima.
Yes, sir.
Double derivative अगर positive बन रहा है तो minima आता है, negative बन रहा है तो maxima आता है.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now you can do this.
So is there any difference like between finding the local minima and temporal minima?
मैं देखिए इसमें ना बड़ा अच्छा सा example देता हूँ मैं. ठीक है. देखो हर दुनिया का ना absolute minima और absolute maxima, लोकल मिनिमा और लोकल मैक्सिमा होता है. जैसे कि क्या है, दुनिया में बहुत सारे गुंडे हैं ना, हर एरिया में गुंडा होता है. आई बिलीव देयर इज अनदर क्लास इन दिस लिंक. ठीक है, मुझे एक मिनट दीजिए, मैं ना एक टीम से बात कर लेता हूँ. क्या दूसरी क्लास है? नहीं है.
श्योर सर.
गिव मी वन मिनट.